Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this presentation titled High Density PET Core Material for Use in Wind Blade Applications. My name is Stefan Reutlev, I'm the Marketing Manager of Armacell. I will start by giving you a short introduction to Armacell as a company. Then I will go a little bit more into details on the PET foam core solutions we have today. And then I will get to the main topic, which is how we can use high-density PET foam cores to replace or substitute end-grain balsa material in wind blade applications. Armacell is a global leader in flexible foams for equipment insulation, basically to keep hot things hot and cold things cold. But we are also a multi-material and multi-product company. In essence, we are specialists in foaming polymers. We have a headquarter in Europe with more than 3,000 employees around the world, with 16 production facilities in 16 countries and a turnover of more than 640 million euros last year. Armacell has today two business divisions, the traditional advanced insulation products still are taking up more than three quarters of the turnover. These are the flexible foams for insulation, mainly used in the building and construction industry. But then we also have the engineered foams division, where we have different types of high performance foams for more specialized applications. Here we are including PET foam products, and this is the fastest growing segment of the company. Our products are then used in different applications like wind energy, automotive, transport, sport and leisure, etc. So what are making Armacell and our products unique? Well, we are the pioneers to produce a product and moving from bottle to product towards a circular economy. So instead of using virgin PET to produce a foam core material, we are instead taking old PET bottles that has been flaked. And this is what you can see in top right corner. And then we run this through an internal granulation line so that we can produce a consistent and high quality raw material for other products. This is what you see in top left corner. And then we can run this raw material through an extrusion process to produce different products. And one of these are the structural foam core material that then can be utilized in the production of, for instance, wind turbine blades. The advantage with using PET is that it's fully thermoplastic. So that means that any waste we have in our own production, sawdust, offcuts, whatever, we can directly reutilize in producing new core material. And after kitting, for example, after producing a core material kit for a blade, we can take back any offcuts from that operation and also produce new raw materials. So we're always minimizing the waste put into the landfills, etc. In the end, if we can also separate the core material from the other constituting parts of the end product, we can again recycle this material into new PET products. So this makes for very environmentally friendly PET foam solutions. Our structural PET cores are used in different types of composite sandwich structures like wind energy blades. This is then an innovative and very eco-friendly solution for this kind of products. This is a patented recycling technology with the lowest possible ecological footprint for this type of products. The PET that we have reused is equivalent of 1.5 billion PET bottles this year, and we are now continuing to produce PET core material at the rate of something like 700 million bottles a year. The PET raw material that we produce can be used in different types of PET based products. The most commonly used and used in wind energy blades is the Armaform core. It's a structural foam core material. But then from the same raw material, we can also do the Armaform foil, which is a thinner, flexible or semi-flexible sheet in thicknesses from say 2 to 6 millimeters. And then we also have produced a new innovative product, the Arma Shape, which is a particle foam product. All these products you can get in different densities, and because the mechanical properties are directly linked to the density, you can always optimize your structure with the most suitable density for the end product requirements. Since we started supplying PET core material for the wind energy industry, we have been used in more than 120,000 blades globally. Typically for a 50 meter blade turbine unit, we are using something like 55,000 bottles. And this results in a saving versus if you would have used virgin PET of 37% in the carbon dioxide emissions. So the advantage of using a recycled PET material in wind energy applications involves excellent fatigue resistance, very good processing temperature, 150°C for longer periods. We have very limited density variations, so very consistent mechanical performance. This gives you a very process versatile material. It can be used with all different kinds of manufacturing processes like infusion or prepregs, and with all common resin systems. It's again thermoplastic, so that means we can also thermoform to single or double curved surfaces, and this opens up the possibility to save quite significantly in resin uptake, for instance. And again, it's 100% recyclable at the end of the life cycle if we can just separate it from the other parts of the blade. So as mentioned before, Armaform PET foam core is today used in more than 120,000 wind turbine blades around the globe. But it can also be used in the nacelles and in the spinners, for example. Over the last 10 years, PET foam core has been used mainly to substitute PVC and balsa foam core in these kind of blade applications. But there is also a significant volume of balsa being used in these applications. But until quite recently, we did not really compete with balsa. But balsa is a wood core material, of course, so it has the same inherited drawbacks of all wood products. You have huge variations in properties, and it's very sensitive to moisture uptake. And this moisture uptake can lead to degradation of the product in the end. So quality control and life cycle cost is difficult to assess, and of course, especially nowadays, the logistical situation of sourcing this natural grown product is quite challenging. If you compare datasheet properties, balsa has quite good properties on paper. So if we, for instance, compare the shear strength, which is arguably the most important property for a sandwich core material, you can see that the balsa has better properties on paper compared to, for instance, a 250 kilo per cubic meter density Armaform PET. But if we instead of comparing these block shear test results, instead compare something which is close to reality and test sandwich beams in 4-point bending, then we can see that the story is different. Actually, here the 250 density beams, PET cord beams, will outperform the balsa ones. So why is this? Why do we see this difference in performance between datasheet and the 4-point bending? Well, one reason is that balsa is normally tested in half-inch specimens, so relatively thin, when you do block shear testing. But you have a thickness effect similar to honeycomb materials. That means that any material that is thicker than half inch will also have lower results. And this is relatively well documented. If you compare the reduction factors, if you go from half inch to 2 inch, you will have a reduction between 25%. If you compare this to our test data, we saw a reduction of 21%, so quite well in line. On the other hand, block shear testing is not so well suited for testing high density PET cores. But if we modify the specimen geometry, we can get up to quite significantly, say at least 25% higher results. So then we also have a good correlation with the results we have from the four-point bending. So this then explains why we can see that the 250 density PT core material has clearly higher shear strength when tested in four-point bending than the balsa beams. But we are now comparing a PT core of 250 kilo per cubic with a balsa 150. So then the beams must be heavier using the PT foam core, right? Actually not, because the resin uptake is density dependent for PT core, so high density PT is quite low in resin uptake. On the other hand, the balsa, even if coated normally, will take up significantly amount of resin when used in an infusion process. So if we take this into account as well, we can actually see that the infused panels with the balsa is significantly higher in weight than the PT cored ones. In this example, for 20 millimeter cored panels, we could see that we had 3.2 kilos higher resin uptake using the balsa than the PT core. And of course, resin is also cost. So if we calculate a cost of the resin of 3 to say 3.5 euro per kilo, we can also show that we are not only saving weight, but we are actually also saving cost. As mentioned before, fatigue performance of PT cores are very good, but they had not really been tested much for high density PT before we started to look into using it in blade applications. But now we've done quite a lot of testing, and we can show that we have at least as good performance for the high density as for the medium density PT cores that have been used in blade applications for more than a decade. So we are well exceeding the requirements set by the NVGL, and if we test the 200 at 65% of static load or the static load level, we can run it for more than 5 million cycles, and then do a static test, and we can see that we have no degradation soever of either the strength or stiffness after these 5 million cycles. So, summing up, the advantages of using a PT foam core instead of end grain balsa in the blade application is that you have no moisture sensitivity, you have excellent fatigue properties exceeding those of the balsa. We have much lower density variation and perfectly flat sheet, which is important when you do the kitting. You have excellent process stability with very good thermal performance. You have the possibility to recycle the core. You can recycle scrap from kitting, etc. today. And at the end of the blade's life cycle, if you can separate the parts, you can also again recycle the core material. It's a core solely based on recycled PT material, so this improves the LCA of the blade and minimizes CO2 emissions. It lowers actually both the weight and the cost of the infused blade, and with better shear strength and ductility than if you would use an end grain balsa. So this concludes my presentation. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions, you can address them either to the Q&A session, or you can send me an email at stefan.reuterlov@armacell.com. Thanks.